Here's something new to learn from Tom. Tom is a 14-year-old schoolboy appearing for a quiz contest for the first time. He may seem excited, but he's a little nervous inside. Anyway, this test is based on the properties of quadrilaterals. To win the contest, he is to pass two stages, and in each stage, he'll be asked three questions. He has to write his solution in the paper sheets, which will be checked in the end to judge whether he's qualified or not. As the questions come, the difficulty levels will increase. And the thing is, mathematics is not his favorite subject. So, before going for the test, he did a small revision of topics related to geometry, like angles, triangles, its properties, and some formulae. Therefore, just to appreciate his participation, he'll be given some clues written on the wall, which will help him when he needs. And now starts the first stage of the quiz. As Tom entered the first room, the first question was announced. You are in a triangular compartment of a room which is in the shape of a parallelogram and divided diagonally into two parts. So your question is, are the two compartments identical or not? The only information given is that he is staying in a parallelogram shaped room and the clues on the wall. This is one of the theorems related to properties of quadrilateral, that diagonal of a parallelogram divides it into two congruent triangles, which he has to prove. Tom looked at the wall, thought for a while, and started writing something on the paper. Tom has started really well, and as we all know, well begun is half done, and so is he. Tom has submitted his first question. Let's have a look at what he's done. Since he was told that he's staying in a parallelogram shaped room, so he drew a diagram ABCD representing a parallelogram, where AC is diagonal, dividing this parallelogram into two triangular compartments. Tom has to prove that these two compartments are identical. So in terms of geometry, he has to prove that these two triangles are congruent. Now, the given thing was ABCD is a parallelogram. That means the side AB is parallel to CD and AC is acting as transversal line. Therefore, angle BAC is equal to the angle DCA. And similarly, angle BCA is equal to angle DAC, where the diagonal AC is the common side for both the triangles. And therefore, triangle ABC and triangle ADC are congruent. Tom used angle side angle criterion to prove them congruent. Very good. Congratulations to Tom. Previous day revision worked for Tom, and now he's got the idea that the clues written on the wall and the first question show that even the upcoming questions may also be on the same lines. Now it's time for the next one. Considering you are in the same room and you have no access to another compartment, prove that the lengths of the opposite walls of the room are equal. Tom is very smart, it seems. He's written the announcement in a mathematical way as, to prove opposite sides of a parallelogram are congruent. He knew that the corresponding angles or sides of congruent triangles are congruent. So even here, he is to show that two triangles are congruent. He then went on to write the whole previous solution with an extra line that corresponding sides of congruent triangles are equal. So AB is equal to CD and AD is equal to BC. Therefore, length of the opposite walls of this room are equal. And then he pressed the buzzer. Very nice. Friends, can you think on the same lines as that of Tom? If yes, then tell me, What if you are asked to prove opposite angles of a parallelogram are congruent? How will you go about it? Here's a clue. The corresponding angles of congruent triangles are congruent. Can you do it now? Let's have a look at this proof. Like previously, he proved corresponding sides are congruent. For the same triangle, we can also write corresponding angles are congruent. Similarly, if we take these two triangles, same thing can be said for this pair of angles. So, both the pairs of opposite angles can be proved congruent. And if you have also thought on similar lines, I would really appreciate that. There may be different ways to prove these theorems. Like in this case only, the opposite sides are parallel. Let's extend these parallel sides a bit. Now, if this is point E, then angle EBC is equal to angle BCD because they are alternate angles, and angle EBC is also equal to angle BAD because they are supplementary angles. So therefore, angle BCD will be equal to angle BAD. Or you can say angle C is equal to angle A. And similarly, we can prove that angle B is also equal to angle D. Alright. And finally, the third and the last question of the first stage for Tom. A little tricky. Now, the room is divided into four parts diagonally so that it makes four triangular compartments. And Tom is placed in one of the compartments. He is to prove these separating walls bisect each other. That means, if ABCD is a parallelogram shaped room and AC, BD are the diagonals and they are intersecting at point E. So Tom is supposed to prove that AE is equal to EC and BE is equal to ED. Even though this question seems difficult, Tom didn't waste much time in starting. No surprise, he attempted this quiz with confidence because he quickly understood that even here, two triangles are to be proved congruent. He took two triangles, triangle ABE and triangle DCE. And as he used previously the properties of transversal lines and alternate angles, here again the angle BAC an angle DCA, which can also be written as angle BAE is equal to angle DCE. And similarly, the other pair of alternate angles, angle ABD is equal to CBD, can also be written as angle ABE is equal to angle CDE. And as he proved that the lengths of the opposite walls are equal, therefore side AB is equal to side CD, so that triangle AEB is congruent to triangle DEC by using angle side angle criterion. We can draw one more conclusion that when a parallelogram is divided diagonally into four parts, two pairs of opposite triangles are congruent. Right? Tom has finished all the questions of the first stage successfully. And he realized while solving these questions that it's easy to prove the properties of quadrilaterals or theorems by using some tools. These tools being the prerequisite knowledge on geometry that motivated him to move towards the second stage. So, if you're also motivated just like him, don't forget to join us in the next session. I hope now theorems are no more difficult for us. So, till we meet next time, keep watching, keep learning. Thank you.